righteous. And man is unrighteous. He's unholy. He's wicked. He's vile. God said it's an abomination for a man to sleep and have sex with a man. God said when a woman leaves her natural affection, she leaves her affection towards her husband. She leaves her affection towards her children. Jesus writes that he's angry with the wicked every day, every single day. And when you stand out here in the face of the law, shouting your obscenities and being active in unrighteous acts, do you think that God is pleased with you? Man is not pleased with you. Have you not ever learned any decency in your life? Will you not just repent? You need to repent and turn to God. You need to ask God to get your anger in control. You need to ask God to be very, very long-suffering with you. Because God has given you opportunity to receive him as your Lord and Savior. And when you choose not to retain God in your knowledge, and you throw God out the window, you open yourself up to be a reprobate. You open yourself up to become a homosexual. You open yourself up to become a lesbian. And that's what you do. You defile yourself one with another. And you turn to murder, you turn to fornication, you turn to every reprobate act that is imaginable in the heart. Well, you need to read the Bible.
No, you should read the Bible.
How about the Bible? What do you want to hear about? Hey, well, the truth like this, why don't we talk about the love of God? The love of God has been bestowed upon you through the death of Jesus Christ. God manifested in the flesh. No man has greater love for his brother than when he lays down his life. There's no greater display of love than for a man to lay his life down for his neighbor. Do you lay your life down? I mean, would you go to war for your country? Would you lay your life down for your country? Are you a selfish, wicked person that wants everything out of your country and you give nothing back? Nothing bad. You spit in the face of the authority of our country. You want to rip our flag down. You want to destroy what God has set up. He gave us a nation that was founded under God, on principles of the Bible, brought forth the Constitution. And you think that you're going to change it just for the lust of the flesh? You are out of your mind. God's word shall stand. You will die in your sin and go to hell. The reason why you die and go to hell is because you have chosen the way of death. You made a covenant with death and hell. You will not open your ears up to the words of life. The Bible says he that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son hath not life. The wrath of God abideth upon you. Shame on you, American. If you don't like the laws of America, go over some other country.